Lesson 189. I feel the love of God within me now. There is a light in you the world cannot perceive, and with its eyes you will not see this light, for you are blinded by the world. Yet you have eyes to see it. It is there for you to look upon. It was not placed in you to be kept hidden from your sight. This light is a reflection of the thought we practice now. To feel the love of God within you is to see the world anew, shining in innocence, alive with hope, and blessed with perfect charity and love. Who could feel fear in such a world as this? It welcomes you, rejoices that you came, and sings your praises as it keeps you safe from every form of danger and of pain. It offers you a warm and gentle home in which to stay a while. It blesses you throughout the day and watches through the night, a silent guardian of your holy sleep. It sees salvation in you and protects the light in you in which it sees its own. It offers you its flowers and its snow in thankfulness for your benevolence. This is the world the love of God reveals. It is so different from the world you see through darkened eyes of malice and of fear, that one belies the other. Only one can be perceived at all. The other one is wholly meaningless. A world in which forgiveness shines on everything and peace offers its gentle light to everyone is inconceivable to those who see a world of hatred shining from attack, poised to avenge and to murder and destroy. Yet is the world of hatred equally unseen and inconceivable to those who feel God's love in them? Their world reflects the quietness and peace that shines in them, the gentleness and innocence they see surrounding them, the joy with which they look out from the endless wells of joy within. What they have felt in them they look upon and see its sure reflection everywhere. What would you see? The choice is given you. But learn and do not let your mind forget this law of seeing. You will look upon that which you feel within. If hatred finds a place within your heart, you will perceive a fearful world, held cruelly in death's sharp-pointed, bony fingers. If you feel the love of God within you, you will look out on a world of mercy and of love. Today we pass illusions as we seek to reach to what is true in us and feel its all-embracing tenderness, its love which knows us perfect as itself, its sight, which is the gift its love bestows on us. We learn the way today. It is as sure as love itself to which it carries us. For its simplicity avoids the snares, the foolish convolutions of the world's apparent reasoning, but serve to hide. Simply do this. Be still and lay aside all thoughts of what you are and what God is, all concepts you have learned about the world, all images you hold about yourself. Empty your mind of everything it thinks is either true or false or good or bad, of every thought it judges worthy and all the ideas of which it is ashamed. Hold on to nothing. Do not bring with you one thought the past has taught, nor one belief you ever learned before from anything. Forget this world. Forget this course. And come with wholly empty hands unto your God. Is it not he who knows the way to you? You need not know the way to him. Your part is simply to allow all obstacles that you have interposed between the Son and God the Father to be quietly removed forever. God will do his part in joyful and immediate response. Ask and receive. But do not make demands nor point the road to God by which he should appear to you. The way to reach him is merely to let him be. For in that way is your reality proclaimed as well. And so today we do not choose the way in which we go to him, but we do choose to let him come. And with this choice we rest, and in our quiet hearts and open minds, his love will blaze its pathway of itself. What has not been denied is surely there, if it be true and can be surely reached. God knows his Son and knows the way to him. He does not need his Son to show him how to find his way. Through every open door, his love shines outward from its home within and lightens up the world in innocence. Father, we do not know the way to you, but we have called and you have answered us. We will not interfere. Salvation's ways are not our own, for they belong to you, and it is unto you we look for them. Our hands are open to receive your gifts. We have no thoughts we think apart from you and cherish no beliefs of what we are or who created us. Yours is the way that we would find and follow, and we ask but that your will, which is our own as well, be done in us and in the world, that it become a part of heaven now. Amen. For more A Course in Miracles video teachings, our study groups, podcasts, self-study courses, articles, and personal A Course in Miracles coaching, access our website at MiraclesOne.org.